my first ever like on-floor restaurant job. I ran the front part of a cafe that this guy Buzzy O'Keefe owned, who was kind of like a famous OG New York restaurateur. So he had Pershing Square, River Cafe, the Water Club. So I ran the front part of Pershing Square, which is right by Grand Central across the street, and was like crazy busy. So that was my first experience ever working in a restaurant. And then that led me to feel as though I wanted to write more. And I got hired by Bon Appetit and moved to LA. And I went from Bon Appetit to Eater. And that's kind of like how it all started. I just love to eat. I grew up in a very food-centric home. Basically, I started cooking probably when I was maybe 4 or 5 years old with my grandmother. My grandmother and my grandfather owned a hotel in the Czech Republic, and my grandmother was actually the chef at the hotel. I had a very non-American upbringing, and more so European style. So the rule of my family growing up was, for myself and my brother, you have to try everything once. So I never ate things that like American kids ate. So for example, I never had chocolate chip cookies. I never had sandwiches. It was just not something my parents really served. I always credit my grandmother for instilling a love in food and hospitality. And you know, you sort of think about like, if you made a different decision, where would your life be, right? So without her, I literally have no clue where I would be sitting. I feel really grateful to her for shaping my life. You know, there's different ways to look at the term wellness. It can be what you're eating, it can be how many hours you're working, it can be, you know, what you're dealing with in your work environment. So there's so many ways to sort of look at that as a holistic term. But now we're starting to see a shift slowly, and I hope to see more of that in the future. I think we're starting to see that a little bit now, but not enough. I write a lot about food and drink, but you know, in addition to that, wellness is a big interest of mine. I think but you know, for a restaurant, I think it starts with whoever's running the kitchen and the lifestyle and sort of the energy they're putting out and what they're showing their employees or their other cooks, and I think it sort of trickles down from there. Health and wellness is so important, and I think especially being in the hospitality industry, in the restaurant industry, whether you're a chef or whether you're even behind the scenes and part of your job is to eat food all the time, you know, having balance in your life is so important. And for me, when I lived in Los Angeles, I was the editor of Eater LA, and part of that job was very social. You know, I was very competitive about what I did, and I always wanted to get the scoop on a new restaurant opening, and so I was out every night. For years, I dined out 6 nights a week. Coming to New York, I realized I didn't have access to food that was as clean as I had in LA, and I started cutting out a lot of refined sugars, so like white sugar, and then you know, some carbs and bread and things like that, and I felt such a big difference in the way that I felt, while also incorporating adaptogenic ingredients, so different types of herbs, different types of amino acids, incorporating like different types of algaes. I started making all these different types of nut milks instead of dairy milk, getting like really nerdy about medicinal mushrooms and reishi and chaga and cordyceps and all these different adaptogenic herbs. And you know, to this day, our kitchen is like, our pantry is like an apothecary of ingredients, yeah, that like most people have no idea what they are. Yeah. You can explain things like this to people, but when you make a change in your lifestyle and you feel different, that's, yeah, what sells you on it. Like with anything, it's about balance, yeah, and I don't not eat pizza, I don't not eat bread, I just, you know, it's in moderation, and if I'm gonna eat it, I want a great version of it. My approach to that is I don't like to be negative. So if I don't like a restaurant or I have a bad experience, I just don't cover it. You know, I only cover places that I think are doing a great job, that deserve media exposure. And I feel like that's a better way to sort of approach it. And I think now, as we're all coming out of a few years of COVID, right, the restaurant industry has been hit so hard. So I don't want to make it harder for anybody else to run a restaurant. So with regard to sustainability, I think there is more of an effort to focus on sustainability in different ways, whether it's ingredients, packaging, you know, electricity. I definitely believe there are restaurants that are attempting to embrace sustainability more. That could even be, you know, related to fishing, right? You can use that term in so many ways. I think there's a long way to go. You know, for me, it's a lot easier being at home, but for a restaurant, It's really challenging, but I think one of the biggest problems is the use of plastic by the industry. I'm honored that you guys want me to be involved. I, as you of course know, am more of a writer, but I have been cooking my whole life. So even though I'm not cooking professionally, I feel like I have a grasp of food for, you know, the sense of a home cook. And I'm honored that you guys have picked me to be part of the group.